Then it happened, inevitably and yet wholly unexpectedly. Some bold soul responded, and an entire city was surprised and a little embarrassed that they had not thought of doing the same. It was simple. One day, the bridge was broadcasting, uh-oh, and the next day, the graffiti had been replaced with an equally confounding message painted in a distinctly different style. When? Blip nearly choked on his delight at this turn of events and called me every hour to talk about it so he wouldn't burst and tell someone else. I'll let it be for a while, he resolved, but I'm gonna have to respond. What will you say? How should I know? I don't even know what we're talking about. This was not the case with everyone else, who now debated their personal takes on the graffiti exchange at every opportunity. Local religious zealots claimed it was an omen from on high or thereabouts, while employers pointed out that the number of sick days taken by their employees had plummeted since the enigmatic declarations had appeared. One local columnist offered his own wry observations, claiming to be surrounded by morons and casting himself above such desperate ridiculosity. He was relieved of his column following a torrent of angry letters from readers. Wise guy. And so it developed. Public enthusiasm for what came to be called Graffiti Bridge was overwhelming. Mayor Punchinello originally decried the graffiti as a blatant show of disrespect for the law and a scar upon the landscape, and vowed to put whomever was responsible behind bars. He toned down his rhetoric immediately, however, after a public outcry ensued when someone leaked to the press that he had ordered the bridge sandblasted. The mayor's spokespersons immediately denied the rumor, what with an election in November, and the graffiti stayed.